talking about new and shiny Mockito 2. Before we start, a few words about me. I specialize in automatic testing and things related to code quality in general. In addition, I am an enthusiast of widely defined concurrency and continuous delivery. In addition, I am an open source project author and contributor, including authoring of Java 8 add-on for Mockito and creating a Mockito ref card. Furthermore, I'm a blogger and a trainer. For a living, with a group of passionate geeks, we create a software house Codarte, which is targeted at clients who care about the quality. And in addition, I conduct training for Bottega IT Minds. And a small personal plug, I've been creating tools for years, and I would like to do it even more. Therefore, currently I'm open to new interesting opportunities from the companies which create tools, internal tools to streamline their development process, and from the companies which create tools for others. Especially if those tools would be related to continuous delivery, reactive things, microservices, testing, and quality in general. One more thing, in a case of questions, feel free to ask me during the presentation. Just raise your hand or draw my attention in some other way. I will try to answer them. My plan for my goal for this presentation is to present to you new features and changes in Mockito 2, and to encourage you to make an upgrade as soon as you will be back in your with your projects. And by the way, I realize it's almost lunchtime, therefore I will try to finish up a little bit earlier to give you an opportunity to catch a good spot in a queue. The plan for my presentation, I will talk about things related to Mockito matchers. I will talk about Java 8 support and about new techniques which were added to improve your test quality even more. There will be something about internals, things which have changed under the hood, and about mocking final stuff. There will be a point about common migration issues, because I want to encourage you to make a migration, and about things related to infrastructure, and also we'll see what the future holds for Mockito. Let's start with some facts. I have two questions to you. Who of you haven't heard about Mockito at all? Okay, one, two, three. People, I don't know where have you been all this time. However, there's still a hope for you. And another question, who of you haven't already migrated to Mockito 2? Okay, more than half of you. So I will try to encourage you to do that. With quite high confidence, I can say that Mockito is the most popular mocking framework for Java. There were some surveys, there were some researches based on the artifacts available in Maven Central and on GitHub projects, and Mockito itself is in top five or even in top three of all Java libraries at all. Therefore, if it's so popular in general, it has to be the most popular mocking framework for Java. The project is very mature. It's actively in development, going on 10 years now, and I would say it's the industrial standard. Of course, there are some alternatives. First of all, Spock. Spock is a very great testing framework, which are used on daily basis. The specification tests in Spock are written in Groovy. And thanks to that, thanks to Groovy magic and Spock magic, it is possible to get much more than with JUnit and Java. Therefore, I encourage you to give Spock a try in general. However, even with Spock, there are situations when the mocks available in Spock do not have some features which are useful. For example, it's problematic to put a mock from Spock in the integration context, for example, with Spring or Spring Boot. Therefore, even with Spock, Mockito can be useful in some cases. And if you use JUnit, you have to use Mockito. There's also JMockit, which is okay. However, Mockito is nicer. About Mockito 2, the first stable version has been released in the fall of 2016. It's been after almost 2 years since the previous stable version from Mockito 1.10. And in the meantime, over 100 beta versions have been released. I will come back to that topic later on. Currently, Mockito is actively developed by 4 core developers and a group of over 100 contributors. Let's start with the matchers. Matchers in Mockito have been improved, have been changed in Mockito 2. First of all, they've been decoupled from Hamcrest. There are no longer Hamcrest matchers. Mockito are matchers itself. And thanks to that, there will be no problem with potential issues with incompatible changes in Hamcrest, which was used as a dependency. As a result, you need to migrate. There's a new base class, which could be useful in migration. However, Mockito Hamcrest matchers, you can still use them if you need some more complex stuff. You just need to use another class, as Hamcrest is already compile-only dependency of Mockito. The behavior has been made more consistent, and another question to you. What do you think was the matching result of the matcher named Anne with a class given as a parameter? Anyone, please shout it to me. Okay, you can be confused, probably not only you, because in Mockito 1, it turned out that there will be no checking if argument is null value. And in addition, there was no check that it's in fact an object of given class. So you could pass there many different things. And in Mockito 2, there is stronger type checking. So you will not be able to pass something that it's not an instance of given class. In addition, null values are not permitted by default. We felt that it's good to do that change. And after the feedback received from the community, it assured us that it's the good direction to follow. To sum up the behavioral changes in Mockito, if you need to match not everything, you need to use any matcher, which will match everything, including null values. If you use any with a class, there will be a check if this is not null object and null value. And in addition, an instance will be checked. For instance, only list will no longer accept collections. It has to be non-null list. And if you really need to pass null object to mock, you can use just null, but sometimes if you have other matchers in Mockito, you have to use Mockito everywhere. Therefore, its null matcher can be useful for you. In the meantime, the API in Mockito has been enhanced. I am a big propagator of BDD-like syntax, given when done in tests in general. In my opinion, they can create more compact, more structured, and easier to really read tests. Mockito has support for given will syntax, which follows the convention given when done. However, it's not as popular as when done. And another question to you, how few use given will instead of when done? Come on, 5 people. Unfortunately, Stack Overflow, even in some parts of documentation, when done is promoted as the default stuff. However, if you would like to give a try given when done syntax to make your test even more consistent and easy to read, then you have syntax given will, which is available in Mockito starting with version 1.8, so years ago. In the last, one of the last versions of Mockito 1.10, there was another alias for verify added named then. And thanks to that, you can match the last block then of your test even more. So to convince you to use that syntax, in given, you just have stuff to prepare your objects and prepare your mocks. So stop your mocks and probably to inject it into the object under test. In when, you execute operation that you would like to test. Usually it's in focused unit test, it's just one operation to test. And you have then section when you usually assert the result, and in addition you can verify interaction on mocks. And within Mockito 2, then alias has been improved to have all what verify is able to do. Therefore, you can do verification order, or you can verify no more interactions or on a given mock. In addition, given will has been improved to be more adjusted to classic Mockito style of mocking, and some methods have been added, some have been renamed, and thanks to that, BDD Mockito with given when then like syntax support is currently the first class citizen. Therefore, you have no excuse to use anything else if you use given when then in your tests. Java 8 is a quite popular Java version nowadays, and therefore Mockito has dedicated support for it. By default, Mockito methods when unstopped, Mockito methods, unstopped methods of stubs or mocks, by default returns a default value like zero for primitives, empty collections, and for optional and stream, starting from Mockito 1, from Mockito 2, there is a default answer empty optional and empty stream, which makes it easier because you don't need to do it on your own to prevent null pointer exception. In addition, some methods in Mockito API have been simplified because in the past it was needed to pass a type of an object as a method argument to prevent a compiler warning. In Mockito 9, the type inference has been improved, and those methods could be simplified. In addition, in Java 8, default methods, in addition to static methods in interface, have been added. And those methods, also known as defender methods, are quite popular to provide backward compatibility. If you have an interface and you would like to add some method, you risk that all implementations that you know and that could be in the universe will be broken because of compilation error that method is not implemented. Therefore, default methods are often used also in Java 8 JDK to ensure backward compatibility. And in that cases, very often you don't want to test those method code in working with some objects that just use those methods. Those methods have to be tested on their own. However, working with those methods, default methods, very often you would like to use it in your mocks. Therefore, even when working with mocks on interface, you can tell Mockito to call real methods, existing methods, using the syntax will call real method, which you probably could know from working with spice. Mockito 2 provides better support for inline matchers. If you would like to create a matcher, simple matcher, you can use argdat and provide a lambda, and that lambda will be executed. Boolean value will decide if a given matcher should match something or not. There is a counterpart to create inline answer, and thanks to that, you can just call additional answers.answer and can provide lambda, which could be useful in some simple cases to simplify your code. However, please bear in mind that Mockito 2 is still Java 6 compatible. Therefore, some or many features, many things which could be better implemented for Mockito for Java 8 are not available in Java in Mockito 2, and it will be the full support for Mockito for Java 8 will be available in Mockito 3, and I will come back to that topic later on. Please remember about questions in case you have any. Another thing that I would like to mention is an ability to tweak Mockito behavior in Mockito 2. Mockito, as I already mentioned, Mockito mocks are lenient by default. Therefore, if you have a mock and you create and you call a method on that mock that was not stopped, you will get a default value. As opposed to, for example, easy mock, where that invocation would fail the test with message that unexpected collaboration with invocation of mock has been detected. It's quite nice because you do not over-specify your test. However, sometimes it can lead to a problem that you have assertion error because you expected to be something to be returned, but you have null, for instance. And if your test is quite big, you have a few or several mocks, and in addition there are several stubbing on those mocks, it's not often very visible where the problem is. Here we have a simplified implementation of that given test. We have a ship database, which allows us to search for ships by name, by production year, and other stuff. And under the hood, it uses ship indexes, our ships, our enemy ships, and so on. And in the test, we would like to test that if we try to find a ship by name, the underlying index will be used. And in that case, when we execute the test, we see that we expect enterprise D to be returned, but we have an empty list. Of course, it's just a few lines, so probably you already spotted that there is a typo. There's a typo that we have enterprise without E. However, having several lines of stubbing, it's not so easy to detect that issue. What we can do with that? How Mockito can support us? In Mockito 2, there is a mechanism to detect a method execution on stub, which has been stubbed with some other values. It means that if we stub given a mock with some value and we execute it with something else, we will get a warning. However, how few read warnings? And fortunately, you are able to enable a strict mode on demand. To do that, you need to use Mockito JUnit rule. By the way, to initialize mocks created with at mock annotation, you need to use Mockito runner, Mockito rule, or do it on your own in before block. Starting with Mockito 2, runner is not yet deprecated. However, Mockito rule is a preferred method to do that. With runner, with JUnit runner, there was some problems. For example, they cannot be combined with other runners very easily. And in addition, some matchers cannot be, some runners cannot be combined with other matchers, runners at all. And therefore, Mockito rule is dedicated, it's a recommended method to use because it does whatever we want with Mockito, and it's much more comfortable to use. And to enable that mechanism, you need to create a Mockito rule. And in addition, you need to instruct mocked to use strict mocked, strict mode for that mechanism. By default, it's just warning. As a result, you will get a nice error method about potential stubbing problems. And you clearly see that given mock was stubbed with to be called with enterprise, but was called with some other stuff. In addition, you have a link to a line where stubbing took place and where real execution took place, which is nicer than having just a pointer to assertion that failed. In addition, another mechanism in Mockito is an ability to do soft verification on mocks. It's a counterpart for soft assertion from assert J. And by default, Mockito will fail on the first verification, mock interaction verification that was not fulfilled. However, sometimes, especially with integration tests, we would like to see all the list of verification that was not fulfilled. To do that, it's just enough to use Mockito rule with dot collector. And thanks to that, everything will be done, because under the hood, Mockito will be instructed that at the end of method, in teardown method, here implemented as a rule, a soft verification will take place. As a result, we have a nice error message that two verification have not been fulfilled. Another mechanism is an ability to detect unstopped stubbing in your mocks. Again, or maybe not again, but if you use TDD, usually there is no problem because you write your test first, later write code, so it's hard to overspecify your test. However, very often, especially if you have very large code base with large tests, and especially if you use copy-paste method to create your test, just take one test, copy-paste another test, and there are several stubbing. So why should I invest time to investigate which are needed in my new test? I will just leave it as it is. If my test passes, it's okay. And therefore, here another simplified example. We have two stubbing, which are probably not very needed here. And if we enable that mechanism with JUnit rule, we'll get an unnecessary stubbing exception, which can give us a hint that there are two unnecessary stubbing in our code, in our test, and maybe we would like to remove them. However, that mechanism, it's not perfect. Probably some of you could argue that in the previous case, some extra stubbing could be useful to show your intention. And very often, or quite often, it is possible to have false positives that Mockito claims that you should not stub it, but you would like to do it because your intentions are more important in that given case. In addition, that mechanism is still work in progress, and for instance, you are not able to use it with given will or when then syntax, because it is only supported with will return or then when syntax, which usually is limited to void method stubbing and for working with spice. So be aware of that limitation of that mechanism. All the three cases that I already mentioned are by default enabled with JUnit in warning mode. You can enable strict mode. However, in case you are using TestNG or something else for Java, you may need to, you can do it on your own. It is enough to create a Mockito session object, initialize it, and later finish mocking, and the mechanism will work as previously with JUnit. Of course, it would be a good idea to put it in some base class to do not clutter your every test with that infrastructure code. Okay, things under the hood. What changed? And the bigger change under the hood in Mockito is a replacement of CGLib with ByteBuddy. ByteBuddy is a nice new bytecode manipulation library, and one of the biggest features of ByteBuddy is, in comparison to CGLib, is a fact that it's actively developed. It was very problematic to work with CGLib in the past. In Mockito, there were some long-standing issues because CGLib was not actively developed very long. And in the past, guys from Hibernate had to migrate to Java Sys because some issues were very problematic to them. And in addition, even pull requests to CGLib were not merged because there was no actively working maintainer on CGLib. It's nice that we have good support for changes in ByteBuddy, but ByteBuddy has also good support for Java 8 and Java 9 stuff. In addition, for those of you who have ever tried to use CGLib, probably agree that it's hard. With CGLib, it was hard to write everything. It was not intuitive, and with ByteBuddy you have a fluent, modern, and very intuitive API with code completion, and it's ByteBuddy helps us to create a nicer helps us to create bytecode manipulation code. Last but not least, ByteBuddy is becoming quite popular. In addition to Hibernate and Mockito, it's already used in Bazel, Spok, Utility, and more. And in the next Hibernate version, it will be probably the default bytecode manipulation mechanism for Hibernate in the next major version. Another thing is related to artifacts. And another question to you, who of you use Mockito core in your project as a dependency? Okay, seven people and Mockito all. Okay. More people than Mockito core, and for those of you who choose Mockito all, I don't have a good news because it was not the best possible way. Probably other people in the room were not sure which dependencies use of Mockito, and Mockito all is a bunch of legacy stuff from ant times, so 10 years ago or so, and in those times to add a dependency to your project, you needed to download jar from the internet manually, put it in the lib directory in your project, commit it to your SCM, usually CVS in those times, and then your dependency was added to your project. However, so it was useful to have Mockito with a bunch of Mockito dependencies in one jar. Of course, it's no longer needed with modern dependency management tools like Gradle. And in addition, it was problematic, for example, to override the version which was bundled with Mockito because it was not shaded. It was just put in a jar. Therefore, sometimes you could have some issues. However, the good news is that with Mockito 2, you don't have a choice anymore because, fortunately, Mockito all artifact has been discounted. This is no longer published, and you have to use Mockito core, Mockito all was unfortunately more popular than Mockito core, probably due to an awareness of the problem under the hood. Okay, so miscellaneous. For example, Mockito has native support for Android. There is a separate module, Mockito Android, and under the hood, proxy class for Dalvik virtual machine is created. I'm not an Android developer, however, as I heard, it is enough to add Mockito Android to Android test compile configuration, and it should work automatically. In addition, Mockito 2 introduced a mechanism for mocking final stuff, so final method, classes, enums, which in the past was possible only with PowerMock or PowerMockito. And it is implemented thanks to the new mocking mechanism in Mockito, possible to use thanks to ByteBuddy, which under the hood uses a combination of both Java instrumentalization API and subclassing. It is not enabled by default. You need to do it on your own, but it's just enough to create a file, put that content in that file, and it will be turned on. There is no other dependency needed to add. Why it's not enabled by default? It's quite young mechanism and quite different mechanism. For example, there could be some problems, some conflicts with other Java agents doing on-the-fly instrumentalization. For example, a few weeks ago, there was a problem with Jacoco agent due to some bug in Java 8 and Java 9, which is not fixed yet. There is a workaround implemented. However, in the future, there could be some issues with other agents. Therefore, if you need to use to stop final things in your project, please use that mechanism and give a feedback what was the problem of, or if it worked for you as expected. And there are some limitations. You cannot stop private native methods. And in addition, methods with package access in a Java package are not possible to mock or stop. Another small thing in a small enhancement is a better support for mocking builders. Sometimes when we have builder like that, it's not enough to mock, to stop a build method, because those methods are very often chained, and having method which by default returns null could cause a null pointer exception. You would need to stop all the methods which would be executed from your class under test, and it could be not very easy to do. It was verbose. With Mockito 2, we have another default answer type. You can say that this mock will return self by default. In that case, Mockito will check if given method accidentally returns type which is the same as a type of a mock. In that case, Mockito will try to return mock itself. Thanks to that, those two methods will return mock itself, and it's enough to just stop a build to create the object which we need. So it's easier to work with builders in that approach. Common migration issues. I hope that we'll try to make a migration. And in fact, migration, it's Mockito 2, it contains incompatible changes. Mockito, starting with Mockito 2, Mockito tries to follow semantic versioning guidance. And Mockito 2 should be backward compatible with any further Mockito 2 version should be backward compatible with Mockito 2. However, migrating from Mockito 1 to Mockito 2 requires some changes. And first of all, you need to modify a package for matchers. It can be done automatically with find replace, so it should be not a problem. However, the more strict checking types could be problematic depending on the style that you've been creating, in which you were creating your test. There could be some changes to do if you try to put a null everything as n null. In that case, it will be not accepted anymore. So there could be some failing tests, but it's good for you because it would improve the quality of your test even further. In addition, you need to remember that, for example, analyst will no longer accept any collection, so there are some nuances regarding matchers. I already probably mentioned not null if you need to check null explicitly, and you need to check base class matchers to Mockito Hamcrest if you need to use Hamcrest matchers in the new version. Mockito all to Mockito core migration, you have no choice, but it's just one line in your configuration Maven or Po on Gradle. And the biggest problem could be with internal stuff. In Mockito 2, many internal things have been removed, moved to some other packages, renamed, or some other stuff, other things happened to them. And for tools like PowerMock or CatchException, it's a disaster. On the other hand, they should not use internal stuff in Mockito. However, with Mockpower Mock, there was an initial version with Mockito 2 support released a few months ago. It's still a work in progress. There are limitations, and for example, under the hood, it still uses CGLib, not ByteBuddy. However, you can give it a try. Using Power Mock or using internals of Mockito in your test, it's problematic to migrate, and you need to wait or modify your test. Hopefully your situation is not like that. Continuous delivery. As I already mentioned, I'm a big enthusiast of continuous delivery, and it's good to know that in Mockito, continuous delivery has been implemented years ago. The artifacts are built on Travis, they are uploaded to Bintray and synchronized with JCenter and Maven Central. And in addition, there is a mechanism for release notes generation. Thanks to that, you don't need to create changelog manually. It's generated based on issues and PRs on GitHub. And there is a nice changelog generated with links to contributors, issues, and so on. It's nice. Continuous delivery is nice in general. In case of libraries, after your pull request is merged into master, it's just a few, maybe several minutes to have your feature available as a next stable version. So no longer you need to use snapshot waiting half a year for some library to release some new version, because releasing process is very time consuming, for instance. However, there are some issues with that approach. For example, already mentioned a lot beta versions, and we had some complaints that, for example, one guy had problem with NetBeans, where having code completion in POM XML was problematic because the large number of versions of Mockito. And there are some other complaints that could be done better, and to answer that, those problems, Mockito team developed the new continuous delivery pipeline for Mockito, and currently every new version is released only to a separated Bintray repository. If you would like to use every version, you just need to add that Bintray repository to your Gradle or Maven, and you will get every possible version, sometimes more than one version per day. To Maven Central or JCenter, only notable versions are synchronized. Notable change is a change version, is a version with at least one change, which was marked by Mockito developers as notable in GitHub. And those versions are automatically migrated to Maven Central and JCenter. Therefore, you have a choice which the frequency of update you can choose, what should be, how often you would like to get Mockito versions. And of course, every Mockito version should have high quality, because there is a bunch of automated tests. However, in some projects, it could be not appreciate to have update every day, because the new Mockito version is available. Okay, what lies ahead for Mockito? And the biggest planned change is better support for Java 8. Mockito 3 will require Java 8 as a minimal Java version, which in turn will allow us to simplify the internal Mockito implementation. In addition, it will be possible to do some new stubbing syntax, leveraging lambdas, and for example, to eliminate static imports, because it will be possible to do default methods in interfaces. And thanks to that, you will just need to implement that interface, which currently is only available in the add-on Mockito Java 8. In addition, there will be declared compatibility with Java 9. Currently, it's problematic to test Mockito 2 itself with Java 9, because Mockito 2 is Java 6 compatible, and there are problems with tools, because sometimes there's no one particular version of given tool which supports both Java 6 and Java 9. So it's hard to do. And for example, there is still no stable ASM library for Java 9. So Mockito 3 will have Java 9 support. And in addition, I need to tell you that there is no ETA for the Mockito 3, so we don't know when it will be released. If you have some great ideas what could be implemented in Mockito 3, please raise an issue, or even better, provide a pull request. Maybe it will accelerate the need to switch to Mockito 3, the main development, because currently the main development is still in Mockito 2 branch, which is occasionally merged into master for the future purpose on Mockito 3. Okay, let's summarize the things. And Mockito 3, if you use JUnit, is the base tool together with AsserJ, which you can use. Mockito provides you some new features which can make your writing your test easier, and to try which can improve the quality of your test in some cases. If you do not use PowerMock or Mockito internals, the migration should be easy to do, and you should not be afraid of it. And Mockito is still in active development, so you can expect even more in the future. And I hope, I encourage at least some of you to migrate your projects to Mockito 2 tomorrow, now on Monday. So that's all I had. Thanks for your attention. About questions, because it's lunchtime, I propose you to go to lunch and I can answer the questions directly. If you have any, please come to me.